Okay, so you have made your video in Adobe After Effects. Okay, you've maybe probably made it in Adobe Premiere Pro and you brought it into After Effects to add some key effects, maybe textual effect, maybe transition effect, maybe you want to do more color grading. But then the key challenge is to export it in the best format ever with minimal size and high resolution. So the usual way is to come over here to composition, and you can come all the way to add to render queue, and you can see the options over here where you select, you can set, check the render settings down here where you click, and you can give the settings. In most cases you keep it at best and then full resolution and many more. Okay, but to export, and after this you can click on OK, and then you can come all the way to high quality or output module, and you can give these details to export. And once you're done specifying the details, you can come and say OK, and then you can start your rendering immediately. But this kind of control, this kind of output usually gives in file that is huge in size, very big file, that because I've tried it and I actually don't like the file size that I've seen. You can export in a very nice format like H.264, and you can have your files in maybe MP4 format, which is H.264 format for your YouTube, for any other use that you may have. Okay, so to export in H.264, usually when you try to check within the composition or within the setting, we try to check within the setting, you will not find that H.264 setting immediately. You have to install Adobe Media Encoder to be able to export in the best settings, or in the settings that you can connect with your Adobe Premiere Pro. So to get Adobe Encoder, you can go to where you download your Adobe and registered version. You can download it and you can install Adobe Media Encoder. It usually come as a pack, the whole software. After installing Adobe Media Encoder, you can come all the way to composition, but this time around, instead of add to render queue, you can add to Adobe Media Encoder queue. Okay, so you just click on this and it is going to open up in Adobe Media Encoder once you have it installed, and you can see it is opening. One thing to note here is it gives you the flexibility to actually export in the best of settings, from different settings, just like the way you used to export in Adobe Premiere Pro. You can have that similar output options to select, and you export your video in the best format that you want. Okay, it has opened our Adobe Media Encoder, and you can see right now the first one is we have the format over here. You can specify the format and you can specify the output location over here. So for example, you can check on this drop down to see the multiple formats that we have. So you can see this is the HD quality, usually comes in the 1080p high definition high quality video. If you have any other alternative, you can go for it. Well, for my own case, I usually go for the highest quality, which is 1080p. So you select it and you specify the locations over here. This is the output file. You specify and you showcase, you navigate around to the location where you want to save it, and you can just select. For example, I want to save it here. You give it a name that you want to give, maybe output one, and then you say okay, you can save. You can see it's in MP4 format. You just click on save. Once you come over here to the top, you can notice that there's a stop icon, top queue, and there's start queue icon over here. So once you click on start queue, you can see it down here, the encoding has started, right? So you just wait to give it some time and it's going to render this video in this format for you in that location. You can see the rendering has started. So while it is working, one thing you should pay attention to is you can pause your rendering and you can stop it at any given time using these icons at the top right. It has just finished the encoding and it has just finished rendering, and you can see it has given us a sign done, and it gives this green tick. Right, ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about how to export your video in After Effects using H.264 format. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.